Good day. Once again, this is Arvin Alonso demonstrating to you basics of IT application tools. In this video presentation, I will demonstrate how to prepare your own template. In this example, I would like to make use of a memo. Why memo? Because in any office for that matter, memo are always released. So you already have a template or format being followed. So say for example, you are the chief of staff of the office of the president and you always prepare a memo. So let's get started. Now, what is important here is you have the developer tab. If you don't have it yet in your computer, in your desktop or in your laptop, you go to File, Options, and under Customize ribbon, you have to check the Developer tab. And then click OK after checking. So you have the Developer tab. And in this Developer tab, I will only concentrate on this area. And I'm going to use only Rich Text Content Control and or Plain Text Content Control. Now, I will be creating another video on how to make use of the other controls here in preparing a template. Okay, so let's get started. So, I already prepared the heading of the institution. Say, for example, University of Piña Chuleida. Okay, and Office of the President. So, I will place here Memorandum Order. Okay, and then number OP dash. Say for example, you have your number series of numbers here. So you can have Rich Text Control and then edit this one. Click the design mode. You can edit this one. Click to enter OP number. So you have that as your guide. Take note, we are on design mode. Next, to whom will the memorandum be sent? So say for example, to, let me just have a tab here, to, then I'll enter again or click again the Rich Text Control and then edit this one, click to enter recipient of memo. Recipient. Or recipients of memo. Okay. Then, what's the subject all about? So let me just have double line spacing here. Subject. Tab. If you don't like to click another again this Rich Text Content Control, you can copy this one and simply paste it here. Edit, click to enter subject. And then date. I will include another control here, and the control will be a date picker content control. Okay, so under date picker, you set the properties. Of course, you can set the properties of this, but it's in the date, it's very important to set the properties, especially the format. what format will you be using on the day? So say for example, this format, the month, the complete month, the day, and the year. And the other settings that you can have. So click OK, and then click to enter date, or click to select, perhaps, to enter or select a date. After that, we can now have the content of the memo. So again here, I'll simply paste what I have selected a while ago, copied a while ago. So click to enter the content of the memo. Then, lastly, you will have the recipient's name. The sender, I should say. So if the sender is the same person, since you are in the office of the president, so you can have already the automatic name of the president. So say for example, I'll press Ctrl U for underline, bold, Dr. Ervin Alonzo. Okay, and then president. So after preparing all of this, you are now ready to save this file as template. So file, save as, you select the location where you are going to save. So say for example, memo UP office. Save as type will be Word template. It will not become a template if you are not going to change the type into Word template. So save. Now let's close this one. So the next time that you're going to prepare a memo in the same computer where the template has been saved, you will now have file, new, and under the personal link here, you now have the template. So once you click this one, automatic, the template is ready. So what you're going to do only when you're using this one, you just click here the one and then type, click the recipient to all of you, for example, subject, meeting, general assembly, date. When we click this one, you can just select the date. Okay? So, and then click to enter the memo, the content of the memo now. So, when you save this one, automatic, it will have a Word document as type. Okay? It will not overwrite the template that you have prepared. So, anytime you're going to use the template, it's still available in the new command of your computer. So, that's all. I hope you learned something new in this presentation. God bless everyone.